Hello guys, today I'm going to teach you about Funuc Layer 3 software. So before getting into this video, we need to know what is Funuc Layer 3 software and why it is used. So before using this software, we should know why, what are all the functions we can do with this software. So then only we can efficiently use this software. Here Funuc has listed some of the main functions here. So first one is input, output, display. Edit of sequence program, monitoring and debugging of sequence program, and another one is setting and display of PNC parameters, and we can do run and stop of sequence program and download upload of sequence program and writing sequence program to flash ROM in print of sequence program. So these are all the main functions are available in Funuc Layer 3. Okay, so what is PMC sequence program? What is PMC? Okay. Already I have made some video tutorials about Funuc PMC, what are all the functions inside, what are the registers we have. So those are all listed in the Funuc playlist. Then you can go to the playlist and you can watch all the videos. So right now, what is the role of PMC? See, I have a CNC machine. So in that CNC machine, I just turned on my power. I just want to run my machine in jog mode. So how the CNC will identify the machine right now in jog mode? So through PMC, we are sending signal to CNC. Hey, CNC, I just want to run my machine in jog mode. So you just switch your mode into jog. So this job is done by PMC. Okay, there is no link between IO signals, machine IO signals and CNC. So through PMC only we are linking. Okay. Through G signal and AF signal. Through G signal, I'm sending, hey, I just want to run my machine to jog mode. So I will send some G signal to the CNC. So CNC will identify, okay, I'm getting jog mode G code, G signal. Okay, so now I'm switching my mode into jog. So then again, it will give you the confirm. I have switched my mode into jog. So then how PMC will know? So through F signal. Okay, CNC will speak to PMC. Okay, I have switched my mode. Okay, now you can do it whatever you want in jog mode, like that. Okay, okay. So now you understood what is PMC and why we are using it on CNC like that. So now let's get into the video. Okay, this is the Funuc Layer 3 software interface. In this interface, we have file, edit, view, diagnose, ladder, tool, video, help. Okay, so first, let's see how to create a project in this software. So you can go file and click new program, or you can use new. So I'm clicking new. So in this new, if you click the new, we will get some dialog box, program creating window. So in this we can put name, whatever we want we can put. I'm just giving here demo. So here device, you should mention your device. Are you going to program a CNC or robot? You can choose accordingly your program requirement or project requirement. So here I'm giving all. There's no problem with it. So if you click all, then it will mention here as .lad. So this is a ladder file. Now we have to choose PMC type. So in this PMC type, we have a lot of PMC types. So according to your project requirement, you can choose your PMC type. So I'm choosing 31IA or 31IB. So I'm giving 31IB PMC. Next one is PMC path. What is PMC path? Here we have first path, second path, third path, fourth path, fifth path, and DCS. What are all this? So what is mean by first and second? See, I have one CNC machine. In that machine, machining will be different. Machining will be different and loading will be different. Okay, so for that loading purpose, I just want to use servo also. For loading purpose also, I just want to use servo. Okay, so the machine axis will be XYZ and loading axis will be XY. So in the first path, I will control the machining axis XYZ. Okay, in second path, I will control the loading axis like XY, pick and place. That's it. So like that, you can control up to five path, fifth path. Next one is DCS. What is DCS? This is dual check safety. So this is also one type of PMC. This is purely for safety purpose. If you add DCS mean, your machine will be double safety like that. Okay, I will explain it later. Next one is PMC memory. So we have a lot of PMC memories here, A, B, C, D, E. So according to your requirement, you can choose it or you can refer the manual. So what is A, B, C, D, E? I don't have enough time to explain it here. So you can go to the manual and you can study about the PMC memories. Next one is ladder program. It is main or divided. So we can divide like 2 part, 3 part, 8 part, 9 part, like that. Okay, I don't want to do that. I'm just giving main. Okay, so next one is level 3 programming. So if you want to use level 3, then you can select this option. Next one is instruction. Instruction is type of instruction we are going to use in program. So we can choose it here. Standard, extended instruction, or extended floating point, function block, extended floating point. So these are the available options. If you want to use them, then you can use it. Okay. So before getting into this new program creation, you just refer the manual, FunCreator 3 operating manual. So in that manual, everything you can find. Next one is symbol and command. Extended and multi-language command. Multi-language command means we can use it Japanese, Chinese, English, and both language we can display like that. So click OK. That's it. We have created our project. So this is the way how to create project in FunCreator 3. You can follow this procedure for every PMC, for every program. There's no issue with that. This is the program. This is the procedure. So in the program list, we have title, system parameter, symbol command, and IO module, message, and ladder. See, there is no ladder 3. If you want to use ladder 3, then you can click when you create the project. Next, sub program, duplicate coil and collective display. We will see one by one in this video. Okay, so first one is title. What is title? So in this title, we can mention, we will be able to mention what is the name of the machine tool builder, machine tool name, and PMC NC name, what is the PMC program number, and what is the edition number, like that. So these are all the lot of details when we create a new program into the new machine. So at that time we can mention our details so that the machine customer will able to understand, oh, this machine is from this machine tool builder, like that. Okay, so machine tool builder name, like we can take something. I'm just giving the Tamil automation machine tool name, hobbing process, and next one is PMC. I'm using PMC 35i model B, and PMC program number, whatever you want, you can give an edition number. What is mean by edition number? See, right now I have mentioned 13 here. So after that, I'm going to change something into the ladder program. So after changing my program, I can save it as like edition 14. So like that, someone has changed in 13. So now I'm changing in 14. So other persons will identify, okay, this program is 14. 14 means this is identify someone. So like that, we can identify the programs. What are the edition number before? According to the edition number, we can identify, okay, this function is added, this function is removed, like that. For our reference, we can mention edition number. So this is very, very useful for us. Then date of programming, you can mention date and program designed by who is designed the program. So you can mention his name, and drone written by remarks. If you have any remarks, then you can mention it here. Okay, so we will go to the next option. Here we have system parameter. So system parameter, we don't use it that much, but see, this is a counter data type. You can choose binary or BCD and FS0 operator panel. See, FS0 operator panel, you can mention starting address of the key address, LED address, key bit image address, and LED bit image address. If you use IO link, then you can assign here. Sorry, enable and disable here, like by doing clicking. Okay, and you can also here select, you'll be able to select basic group count also. I will disable. So now it will get closed. Okay, so the next one is symbol command. What is symbol command? In symbol command, we have a machine signal, NC interface, PMC parameter, and etc. So in the etc, we have a lot of registers here. First one is machine signal X and Y. So see, I'm clicking 0 to 127. So here we are getting X0, X0.0, X0.7, 1.0. So this is the octal addressing system, addressing format. Okay, in FANUC 0 to 7. Okay, so here we can add symbol first command and second command. Symbol I'm giving start push button like that. First command, whatever you want, you can mention it here to start conveyor and to stop conveyor. So like that, you can mention three type of identification. One is symbol and first command and second command. Okay, for every registers we have here, then you can add symbol, first command, second command. So this is a NC interface signal. So NC interface signal is here 0 to 767, so like that. If you want to just change your symbol, and you can change it here in the using software. Okay, so this is the option for that. The next one is I/O module. So in I/O module, we have input and output. If you connect the software into the online mode, then it will show this address, where is located, in which group, in which base, and in which slot, and which module. You can add command to them. Okay, so see, these are the module names. Suppose if you are working online, then software will show you what is the name of the module and input output bytes, so like that. Okay, so this option is used for that one, that purpose only. Next one is message. What is this message? See, here we have I think you know what is a bits. So if you enable a bits, the machine will show you the alarm, some alarms. So that is the main purpose of the a bits. For example, this is A0.0. In A0.0, if A0.0 gets triggered, I want to display coolant level low. Coolant level low. So whenever A0.0 gets activated, so that time machine will display coolant level low. So then we can easily identify, okay, coolant level low. If the message is not presented, again you have to check your program. And what is the input is coming, why is it activating, so like that. If you had the message, then this will be easy for us to troubleshoot the machine. Okay, to troubleshoot the alarm, what is A0.0, coolant level low. Okay, coolant level low, we need to refill the coolant. Then machine will okay. Then machine is ready to run. So this way we can use this option. We can edit the messages. We can edit the messages for every A devices. Okay, in A we have lot of coils. See, A249.7. So this much of messages is available. We can use it whatever you want in your program. Okay, now I'm closing it. Next one is ladder, level 1 and level 2. Lot of difference. There is a lot of difference between level 1 and level 2. If you use level 1, so in this level 1, the instruction will be executed very fast. But not in level 2. So like that. So I will add separate video. What is the difference between level 1 and level 2, like that. So now I'm going to sub program. What is sub program? So we have the Howing machine. So in the Howing machine, I have conveyor, chip conveyor. So for the chip conveyor, I have to I'm just deciding. I need to make some separate logic for that. Not in machine. I don't want to collapse with the logic in the machine logic. Within the machine logic, so I just want to develop separate logic for the chip conveyor. So now I'm giving subprogram. If you right click the subprogram, we can add subprogram, or you can click in your keyboard F9. This is a shortcut. So I'm giving add subprogram. In this subprogram, we can choose a number. What is the subprogram number? P is common. If you see the P, then that is the subprogram. So in the subprogram, we can create a lot of subprograms. So according to your number, you can choose it. So I'm giving P8. What is the symbol and kind of ladder? We have two type of programming, ladder or step sequence. Okay, I mostly we will work on ladder only, not we will we don't work in step sequence. Then first command and second command. So what is the symbol? Chip conveyor. I'm just giving chip conveyor. Chip conveyor, apply. So now it is open. So inside this sub 71 and sub 72, we can create our logic, chip conveyor logic. So whenever we want the logic, we can call it in sub program. So in level one, we can call it. Next one is duplicate coin. What is duplicate coin? See here they are saying, for example, Y0, Y10.0, Y20, Y30. We will make mistake in our program. We will use Y0 again and again. So to find that mistake, we can use duplicate coin. And next one is collective display. So collective display is if we search x0.0, it will show where we use the x0.0 in our program. So it will show all the runs where we use x0.0. This will collect the x0.0's information where it is used like that. So this is the collective display. Okay guys, thanks for watching. So this is enough for this video. We have seen a lot of information, and you just watch the video and gain the knowledge about Funcalculator 3. We will see in the next video with the programming instructions, how it is used, and what are the programming instructions available, and what are the tools available, then how can we make use of them in the software. Okay guys, if you like this video, then please share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.